Hey, how you going? This is Daniel Monday bringing you my pillar number six in my seven pillars for health and well-being. Today's pillar that we're going to address is stay away from the liquid calories. These are the hidden little baddies that keep people fatter and fatter and that stop people from achieving their optimal weight, their optimal physique, and their optimal health and well-being. What do I mean by liquid calories? Now, I spoke about fad diets earlier, you know, diet shakes and all that sort of stuff. They count. Liquid calories, there's a lot more in those than what you'd expect. The other thing that's a real big is fruit juice, okay? Fruit juice is not healthy. Everyone has been marketed that since they were a kid, and I used to drink juice by the truckloads because it was supposed to be good for you. That's what you're told when you're a little kid. Some nutritionists and, you know, so-called health experts will still try and tell you today that fruit juice is all right. It is not all right. It's full of sugars that makes you fat, okay? The only fruit juice that is healthy is if it has been squeezed right on the spot. It contains nothing except the fruit that it's supposed to contain. There's no preservatives, there's no numbers on the ingredients. It is fruit. If it's orange juice, it's an orange that's freshly been squeezed. Liquid calories, what else will that mean? Things like, when you go to Starbucks and you can get, you know, the big Frappuccino with cream and this and that, and it's not a coffee. If you want a coffee, have a long black. It has like 3 or 4 calories, very minimal. It is nothing compared to what you're going to get when you start adding in all the other extras, the flavorings and toppings and all this rubbish that your body doesn't need. People have a couple of them a day. Guess what's going to happen? Your belly's going to get bigger. It doesn't have to be rocket science, this thing. We just got to implement a bit of common sense. And of course, the biggie is alcohol. Empty calories, as much as I love to have a nice glass of wine or a beer, it is not going to be the way. If you want to lose fat, you got to really, really, really limit that. You can't have a glass of wine with dinner each night, because unfortunately, it is not going to happen. Like I mentioned, you can't out-train a bad diet, and the liquid calories at dinner time that people have are just killing their progress, okay? This is Daniel Monday, danielmonday.com. I'll be in touch for the final installment of my 7 pillars for health and well-being very soon. I'll chat to you then. In the meantime, eat clean, stay lean, over and out.